Furthermore, some people say that the Quran is a deception. When we ask them, what is the origin of the deception? They give no answer. Can you point out a single deception in the Quran? They cannot answer. So how can you say something which you cannot logically prove? There are some people who tell a false thing, who make a false statement, and they fool themselves by sticking to it. For example, suppose there's a person who thinks Mr. A is an enemy. He thinks. He does not have any logical proof. He has no reason, but he thinks, he falsely believes that Mr. A, he is my enemy. The moment he meets Mr. A, that person starts behaving like an enemy to Mr. A. Now, Mr. A, being a human being, he retaliates. Why is he treating me as an enemy? He retaliates. The moment Mr. A retaliates, the person says, didn't I tell you? He's my enemy. See, they're retaliating to me. So you make a false statement, and you fool yourself by sticking to the statement. This is what the critics of Islam do. They make a false statement, and they fool themselves by sticking to it. Furthermore, the Quran, it believes in reasoning. And there are several verses which talk about reasoning. You can analyze it. You can discuss the matter of the Quran. Several places, including Surah Ibrahim, chapter number 14, verse 52. That here is the message for mankind. Let them take warning therefrom. Let them know there is one God. Let the men of understanding take heed. Many Muslims think that the Quran discourages reasoning. It discourages arguing with people. It discourages discussing about the Quran with others and religion with others. In fact, the Quran encourages that you have to discuss with the other human beings. You have to argue with the other human beings. It's mentioned in the Quran in Surah Nahl, chapter number 16, verse number 125. Invite all to the way of their Lord with wisdom and beautiful preaching and argue with them and reason with them in the ways that are best and most gracious. Quran encourages reasoning and arguing and discussing, but with hikmah and husna, in ways that are best and most gracious.